Hello. Today we're going to discuss integer encodings, and in particular we're going to address the problem of how we're going to represent both positive and negative integers. First we're going to talk about C integers just a little bit, and then review unsigned encoding, then we'll take on the signed encodings, and wrap up by talking a little bit about the safety of converting between all of these integer encodings. So here are the integer data types that are guaranteed to be available in the C99 standard. So you can see the minimum and maximum value that can be stored in each of these types. You'll also notice that there are regular signed and unsigned versions of each of these, and you'll notice that the signed versions, so the ones on the top, can store negative numbers, but they don't store quite as many positive numbers. Roughly half of the number space is allocated to negative numbers. So the sizes are the minimum sizes, and in fact, if you were to do some experiments on Stu, you'd find that a couple of the integer sizes that are available to you are actually larger than the sizes mandated by the C99 standard. So I ran these experiments just to show you, and the two that are larger are, in fact, int and long. So those are guaranteed to be at least 2 and 4 bytes respectively by the standard, but they are 4 and 8 bytes respectively on Stu. So just something to be aware of as you work on that machine. Okay, so let's talk about unsigned integer encoding. In fact, we've already talked about unsigned integer encoding. This is what we saw last time. So basically, you just write all of the bits in order from most to least significant, and then store them using, you know, whatever ordering encoding, little endian or big endian, that you're using on the system. And of course, this is unsigned, which means that you can't store negative numbers. And so the way that the textbook demonstrates this or illustrates this is kind of interesting. So they represent this graphically. So each bit in the representation is given a particular bar length. And you'll notice that each one of these bars is twice the length of the bar before it. So this is the value that each of those bits contributes to the overall value. So the first bit contributes a 1, the second bit contributes a 2, and this is going from least significant to most significant, or from right to left if you're writing it in the normal format. So for instance, the number 5 is 101 in binary. So you have the 4 bar and then you have the 1 bar. You add those together and you get 5. And then same for these other examples here. So this is just a little way of visualizing the value that's being stored in a particular number, and it may or may not be useful to you, but I wanted to just mention it as for something for you to notice as you're going through the reading.